Disasters are one of the biggest disruptors of human life. Every decade, 500,000 lives are lost to them. The economic cost of calamities is humongous. Various parts of India are prone to disasters like earthquakes, cyclones, floods, and so on. It's a question repeatedly asked whether modern India could give the adequate attentions to disaster management as it was required. United Nations had declared 1990s as the decade for natural disaster reduction. Towards the end of the last millennium, the state of Odisha faced the devastating supercyclone. Later in 2001, Kutch in Gujarat, the largest district of India, was struck by a massive earthquake, resulting in the loss of thousands of lives. It marked a turning point in modern India's pursuit towards a new paradigm for disaster management. Narendra Modi became Chief Minister of Gujarat a few months after the earthquake. He saw the calamity from a different perspective, in the perspective of Aapda Mein Afsar, as he used to mention it. He introduced a new paradigm of disaster management, based on this concept of converting adversity into opportunity. Gujarat became the first state to introduce a Disaster Management Act in 2003, even before one such law was introduced at the national level. Under Modi's leadership, Gujarat established pioneering institutions for capacity building in disaster management and gave unprecedented importance to preparedness. This was a new beginning towards a resilient India, with Narendra Modi leading the way as a pathbreaker. Modi's experience in disaster handling spans over decades. In 1979, as an RSS activist, he led a major rescue and relief operation after the Morbi floods in Gujarat. Later, as an administrator, he led Gujarat through various calamities. Today, India has come a long way, with better preparedness and advanced risk reduction capabilities, with a strong framework of disaster handling, with a vision for resilience. August 11, 1979. Morbi town of Gujarat experienced an unprecedented event when the Machu Dam breach inundated an entire district. The arrogant waves swept away thousands of men, women and children in Morbi. A young man stood tall to help his people, to take them out of the devastating flood situation and to lend his shoulder of support to the grieving survivors.
मच्छू ओनारत का जो कमांडिंग सेंट्रल था जिसके हाथ में था वो नरेंद्र भाई के हाथ में था, तो पूरा जोश के साथ स्वयंसेवकों को काम लगा दिया। पहले सबकी लाशों निकालो, सबको जो बच गए उसको निकालो, वहाँ रात में कैंप में भेजो और लाश को इकट्ठा करो, अग्नि संस्कार करो, उसका वो सब काम करो।
Narendra Modi and other RSS workers were among the first responders when the disaster struck Morbi.
तो नरेंद्र मोदी राष्ट्रीय स्वयंसेवक संघ के युवा प्रचारक थे। जब बाढ़ आई तो आरएसएस वहाँ राहत काम के लिए जिम्मा लिया और उसको नेतृत्व देने के लिए नरेंद्र भाई को यहाँ अहमदाबाद से भेजा गया। उन्होंने कार्यकर्ताओं की नेतृत्व देने के साथ पूरे राहत कार्य को एक व्यवस्थित गति प्रदान की। इतना ही नहीं, सफाई से लेकर के राहत सामग्री पहुंचाने तक का काम पूरा तन्मयता से साथ किया। मोदी जी मोरबी से 2 महीने रहे, 2 महीने तक कार्यकर्ताओं का नेतृत्व करते रहे, मार्गदर्शन देते रहे और काम करते रहे।
The receding waters had left behind a devastating trail of destruction. A particularly difficult task was to retrieve the bodies. Many of them were in a swollen, decayed, or sometimes disfigured state. Corpses of animals were strewn across the area.
कारण के ये वक्ते मोरबी नी हालत ये भी थी कि भयंकर दुर्गंध मारती थी, पशुओं ना मृतदेह सड़ता है ना वास आउती थी। ये वक्ते અમે બધા કાર્યકર્તાઓ મળદા ઉચકતા હતા, કાદવ કીચડ સાફ કરતા હતા, લોકોને ખાદન સામગ્રી પહોંચાડવાની કોશિશ કરતા હતા.
નરેન્દ્રભાઈને વો સભી ગાંવ મે ઘર ઘર જાકર સફાઈ કે કામગીરી સંભાળી હતી. નરેન્દ્રભાઈ કો દો માસ કે લિયે સભી ઘર ઘર જાકર સભી કો અનાજ વિતરણ કી જવાબદારી સોંપી ગઈ. મેને દેખા હૈ કે નરેન્દ્રભાઈ અપની પીઠ પર અનાજ કી બોરિયા લેકર સભી કોઈ પણ જાત કી હિન્દુ હો મુસ્લિમ હો બિના ભેદભાવ ये अनाज वितरण का उसने कार्य किया है.
Disasters bring with them myriad problems, one after the other. The relief workers need to have a systematic approach to prioritize each of the activities and ensure justified allocation of necessary resources and support mechanisms.
नरेंद्र भाई की दीर्घ दृष्टि से पूरी पूरी अलग अलग टीम बना के ये कार्य किया जाता था. पर डे अलग अलग विस्तार का एक चयन किया जाता था. सब सफाई में, अन्य व्यवस्था में, भोजन वगैरह की व्यवस्था में, घर घर भोजन टिफिन पहुंचाना, जिनको जरूरत हो यहाँ से राजकोट तक हॉस्पिटल ले जाना, ये सब कार्य अच्छी तरह से हो रहा था.
जब ये आरएसएस वाले हमारे लोगों ने पता चला कि ये गांव भी बहुत बुरी तरह से परेशान है, तो तब पूरा आरएसएस वाले के साथ नरेंद्र मोदी जी भी उन साथ में था. सबको रेशन, दाना, पानी, खाने का पूरा बंदोबस्त, फूड पैकेट और थोड़ा भी केस डॉल के लिए पैसा भी दिया, और जो धाबरा वगैरह जो आता है ओढ़ने के लिए वो सबको थोड़ा दिया, कपड़ा भी दिया. सबको जो जरूरत थी गांव लोगों ने 600 से 700 लोगों ने वो दिया.
हम मोरबी गए, 100 मकान नए बनाए. जो लोग के मकान नष्ट हो गए थे उनका लिस्ट हमारे था, उनको वो आप देना था. हमने विश्व हिंदू परिषद अब अमेरिका द्वारा पूरी दुनिया में से फंड कलेक्ट किया था, और वो फंड का हमने उपयोग किया ये मकान वगैरह सब बनाने के लिए.
Disaster management has to be a comprehensive exercise, not limited to relief and rescue. It should cover all aspects of bringing community life back to normal, from rehabilitation to restoring livelihoods. When Modi led the relief activity in Morbi, it was not just immediate relief that was on his mind. He had a vision of ensuring comprehensive rehabilitation. Morbi was the first experience for Narendra Modi to lead a disaster handling exercise. This also marked the beginning of the journey towards building a resilient India based on his experiences of disaster management. Chobari, a tiny village in Kutch district, was known to very few people in Gujarat. However, that changed in a matter of a single day. On the 26th of January 2001, when India had just begun to celebrate its Republic Day, a massive earthquake measuring 6.9 on the Richter scale jolted Kutch. Chobari was the nearest village to the epicenter. The estimated death toll crossed 13,000. Over 2 lakh houses collapsed and over 9 lakh suffered damages. More than 500 people lost their lives in Chobari village itself. On that fateful day, the region found itself broken and paralyzed.
Kafi tabahi mach chuki thi aur mere gaon mein hi 555 logon ki death ho gayi thi aur 2 feet ki deewar kahin bhi nahi bachi thi.
Narendra Modi had been among the first responders to the Morbi dam breach in 1979. 20 years later, he was again among the hundreds who rushed to Kutch.
2001 mein jab bhukamp aaya to Modi sahab bhukamp ke agle din hi turant Kutch aa gaye the. Samakhyali ka ek chhota sa school tha, wahan ke ruke the.
During his stay in Morbi after the dam breach, Narendra Modi had rescued people, pulled out dead bodies, arranged relief, managed resources and created plans for rehabilitation. The Kutch earthquake was a disaster of a much larger magnitude. However, many of the challenges were common, and Modi had solutions that he learned from his previous experiences.
उन्हें जैसे ही भूकंप की सूचना मिली, वे तुरंत वहां से कच्छ पहुंचे और बचाव कार्य का नेतृत्व किया और लोगों में जोश और उमंग भर दिया।
He put all his knowledge into practice. Before becoming Gujarat Chief Minister, the few months spent at the ground level in Kutch gave Narendra Modi deeper insights into what was needed to be done. As an RSS Pracharak since the early 1970s, later as Gujarat Bharatiya Janata Party's organizational secretary and then national leader based in New Delhi, Narendra Modi had developed tremendous goodwill. He was willing to reach out to organizations and well-meaning individuals who he believed would be of help for social good. Kutch was one such instance when he mobilized help from all he knew and more.
Nasliwadi, आप सबको पता होगा कि बॉम्बे डाइंग के मालिक हैं, तो उनका उनका संबंध काफी अच्छा था, तो उन्होंने कहा कि मुझे क्या करना है आप बताइए। तो नरेंद्र भाई बोले कि मुझे बिस्किट चाहिए गुजरात के लिए। उन्होंने कहा कि कितने दो बिस्किट, कि नरेंद्र भाई ने कहा 10 लाख। बोले 10 लाख क्या, तो उससे उन्होंने कहा कि 10 लाख कार्टून। फिर उन्होंने ये कहा कि ठीक है, मेरा पूरा गोडाउन आपका है। करीब करीब 6 महीने से ज़्यादा समय तक कच्छ के हर गांव में आपको बिस्किट मिल रहे थे मुफ्त में।
The earthquake struck in a cold January. People were suffering due to the unbearable weather conditions. Apart from shelter, they needed warm clothing as well. At that time, 1 lakh blankets were arranged from Jalandhar and other areas. Other essentials, including trucks of packaged mineral water, food items, and other essential items, were also arranged.
Government NGOs हैं, private NGOs हैं, उन सबको बुला करके और सबको पीने के पानी की व्यवस्था के लिए मोदी साहब ने बहुत अच्छा काम किया भूकंप के टाइम पे।
और पानी में क्या लाना चाहिए, बोतल वाला पानी लाइए। तो मैंने कहा कि साहब बोतल वाला पानी तो रात को उनको ठंड पड़ेगी, तो 2 दिन के बाद ये बोतल को गर्म पानी अंदर भरेंगे और कंबल या तो कुछ कम है कपड़े तो अभी उनको ये हीटर का काम करेंगे।
Along with leading relief and rehabilitation efforts, as the CM of Gujarat, he also gave shape to his vision of Aapda Mein Afsar to rebuild the state. Narendra Modi's first priority after becoming the CM was to speed up the earthquake rehabilitation program. To achieve this, he traversed the area extensively as he reviewed and supervised the efforts.
Narendra bhai mukhyamantri bane uske turant baad mein wo bhukamp ka rehabilitation ka kaam ki mein gati lana wo unki priority thi. Rehabilitation ki jahan kaam karna hai wo kaam ke sthal ki visit bhi in person hona chahiye. रिव्यू मीटिंग भी सबके साथ में, जिला के फील्ड ऑफिसर्स और सबके साथ में होना चाहिए। सीनियर ऑफिसर्स कंसर्न डिपार्टमेंट के रहेंगे लेकिन इनके साथ में रहना चाहिए, और एकदम पूरा टाइट शेड्यूल होता था।
इन अ सिनेरियो लाइक कच्छ, टाइम वाज ऑफ एसेंस। चीफ मिनिस्टर नरेंद्र मोदी फोकस्ड हिज एनर्जी टुवर्ड्स एक्शन। He told the officials that plans were already in place and it was the implementation that was most important. Modi was ushering in a different and more work-oriented culture and bureaucracy. No aspect of governance was going to be casual. Decisions taken in meetings were converted into government orders. This brought a sense of greater seriousness among all the officers. CM Modi also streamlined the bureaucracy, made it accountable and put the system in tune with his goal of building a new Kutch.
मुख्यमंत्री बनने के 3 महीने के अंदर कच्छ सहित भूकंप के जो प्रभावित क्षेत्र थे उनमें चमत्कारिक बदलाव आ गया। इतना काम हुआ और इतना ज्यादा हम लोगों का आत्मविश्वास बढ़ गया कि जनवरी जब आई 2002 की, तो इन्होंने एकदम सीना चौड़ा करके दिल्ली में आकर के दुनिया के सभी देशों के राजदूतों को आमंत्रित किया गया दिल्ली में और प्रेजेंटेशन किया गया कि देखिए हमने आपकी सहायता से, आपके आपने जो हमको सहायता दिया, देखिए हमने कच्छ में इतने इतने काम कर दिए।
Modi's emphasis on monitoring and review helped to ensure that the relief and rescue work was being carried out efficiently and effectively, and that aid was reaching the people who needed it the most. It also demonstrated the importance of strong leadership and effective coordination in responding to disasters. This led to Kutch bouncing back in a manner better than expected. Another testament to Narendra Modi's philosophy of building back better.
See, in short, if anybody in Asia is doing a post-disaster reconstruction program, particularly after an earthquake, Gujarat model is for them to follow.
The United Nations had designated the 1990s as the International Decade of Natural Disaster Reduction. In India, however, even after 50 years of independence, disaster mitigation and preparedness was unfortunately a rather neglected subject. There was no detailed doctrine on preparedness. In 1999, just 2 years before the Kutch earthquake, another disaster in the form of a supercyclone claimed around 10,000 lives in the eastern state of Orissa. However, it is the Kutch earthquake that thoroughly underlined the urgent need for India to prepare its own models for better disaster management and resilience. Kutch was a moment that helped Modi in developing a model that can be useful for years to come. After the devastating earthquake in Gujarat, Chief Minister Narendra Modi took lead of rebuilding the region, dealing with various challenges. But his top priority was to enhance the state's ability to handle disasters in the future. In December 2001, just 2 months into his tenure, the Gujarat Earthquake Reconstruction and Rehabilitation Policy was introduced. Simultaneously, the Gujarat Emergency Earthquake Reconstruction Project was initiated.
सबसे पहला डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट एक्ट अगर भारत के अंदर किसी ने पास कराया तो वो प्रधानमंत्री ने गुजरात में कराया। इससे पहले के नेशनल डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट एक्ट पास हो, स्टेट डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट एक्ट पास हुआ था। SDMA, स्टेट डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट अथॉरिटी पहले गुजरात में बनी।
नरेंद्र मोदी got teams together to handle specific problems, choosing experts for key roles. Even though he was new to being the chief minister, Narendra Modi and the Gujarat government took a step-by-step approach to fix the housing problem. Modi aimed to be creative and futuristic in building houses and infrastructure. He encouraged officials to learn from other countries, especially Japan, and create their own roadmap for Kutch.
In that first meeting, this Kobe earthquake part, because when I was explaining about this Hyogo Gujarat Friendship Fund, I was impressed that he mentioned in Kobe, like we know that Japan is quite strong in the earthquake safety engineering aspect, it was very good. But he mentioned that in Kobe, the people who died, they were actually the old people and they were used to live in the like two-story building.
Modi emphasized making buildings resistant to earthquakes, even if it meant they would take more time to build. He turned it into an opportunity to build back better, stressing the importance of careful planning and avoiding shortcuts.
The shake table test, which is how you really test on a lab, where you construct model houses and you, with the tractor, you do the impact to show that with this impact, you have two models. Which falls first and how does happen? How the impact works? Because that's a visual impact which you've given. Every village in Kutch, at least they had over 4 times in a year.
The Asian Development Bank's 2008 report about the Gujarat earthquake rehabilitation and reconstruction project talked about how the government, led by Chief Minister Narendra Modi, adopted an approach of building for the future and being ready for disasters. The report said that Modi government focused on smart methods, especially making buildings that can resist earthquakes. They also followed policies like in-situ construction and owner-driven construction, where people had a say in how their houses should be built. This was the first time such a large-scale effort used an owner-driven approach. People even got to choose how their houses would look. The houses were registered under both the husband and wife's names, fully insured, and the Gujarat government was part of the deal.
He said, listen, we should give a plethora of options to the people. One, let them choose, and that should be there in the individual agreement of the financing agreement and the arrangement with the government.
Gujarat government officials had meetings with over 10 lakh households to teach them about building houses. There were not enough trained engineers for the big building projects. So more than 3,000 young students from ITIs and their professors jumped in to help with the work. They used vehicles with projectors to show films in villages where a famous actor explained the key ideas behind earthquake-resistant and owner-driven construction. The whole village would gather to watch. Taking forward his Aapda Mein Avsar model, Modi had already started visualizing a new Kutch, with new facilities and a new life for its people. After the reconstruction, Bhuj city grew four times its size. The roads widened and proper drinking water system was installed. Bhuj and other towns, which didn't have a good sewage system before, got a modern one.
So Modi sir ne kya vision kiya usme? कि सीधे ही नर्मदा का काम जो भी सौराष्ट्र का और कच्छ का एरिया था वहां पे पाइपलाइन बिछाना स्टार्ट कर दिया।
One crucial focus area was the state of schools. Narendra Modi as a leader always emphasized quality education. In 2003, Kranti Guru Shyamji Krishna Verma University was established in Kutch. During the same time, over 35 new colleges were set up and an impressive 1,000 new schools were built in a short span. The medical facilities were severely damaged too. Although some health services resumed in temporary or semi-permanent buildings shortly after the earthquake, the Modi government took on the challenge of creating top-notch medical infrastructure. This included hospitals, primary care and community health centers. Narendra Modi, who had a lot of experience working with people in social organizations like the RSS and later with the BJP, really knew how strong India's community life could be. As the Chief Minister, Modi put a big focus on getting the community involved. The government set up people's committees at the local level, bringing in representatives from different groups like the village head, local NGOs and community members. There was a three-tier structure for the redevelopment work: the village committee, the district advisory committee and the state advisory committee.
Our point was that it's the building technology which matters. We gave training to the local masons and we gave training how to make the proper construction of the an earthquake safe house.
Like your owner-driven construction, actually it's for the entire world, it started from there. In his political meetings, he used to give this. That was the first time this Jan Bhagidari, the participatory planning part of it was thrown out. Otherwise, it is a nice English term only used by international agencies like us.
It was the very first Indian state to make a strong move by creating a law to deal with disasters. In 2002, CM Modi introduced the GSDM policy. Just a year later, in 2003, the Gujarat Assembly passed the GSDM Act. This was even before the National Disaster Management Act, NDMA, came into play in 2005.
He was there, chairman of that GSDMA. I was the member secretary. He told me, my objective is that it should be one of the best administered program in the world. And in 2003, 2004, when there are evaluations by international agencies for the best run programs in the earthquake reconstruction, the Kutch earthquake reconstruction program was adjudged as the best program and the fastest moving program, the fastest implemented program in the world.
Disasters also mean destruction of physical assets and economic disruption. Modi formulated comprehensive long-term strategies aimed at not only generating employment opportunities but also fostering economic growth in the region of Kutch. The reconstruction initiatives were not limited to mere rehabilitation. They were designed to revitalize local industries, support artisans and farmers, and rejuvenate livelihoods. The government implemented an incentive program, offering tax relief to numerous industrial units that had ceased operations due to the earthquake. Farmers received input kits containing seeds, fertilizers and tools. Masons found significant opportunities in the reconstruction of houses and buildings. Additionally, a substantial self-employment scheme targeting women was launched, contributing to the overall economic resurgence in the aftermath of the disaster.
उन्होंने बोला कि नहीं, आप वापी में एक्सपेंशन नहीं करोगे, आप कच्छ जाओगे। तो हमने वो डिसीजन लिया और आज वहाँ पर हमारा एम्प्लॉयमेंट करीब 25,000 लोगों से ज्यादा का है।
नरेंद्र मोदी इम्प्लीमेंटेड अ कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव स्ट्रेटजी फॉर द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ कच्छ, एम्प्लॉइंग अ 360 डिग्री अप्रोच. Central to this strategy was a deliberate emphasis in fostering tourism. Substantial infrastructure was established, complemented by dissemination of readily available information for the convenience of potential visitors. As a result, Kutch now boasts of several resorts, and locals have ingeniously transformed their traditional mud houses or bunga into homestays, emerging as a preferred choice among tourists. The initiation of the internationally acclaimed cultural festival Ranotsav, held in the White Run, marked a significant milestone in unlocking the region's untapped tourism potential while simultaneously contributing to the augmentation of the local economy.
ये अपना जो रण है इसको कोई दुनिया के नक्शे में बैठाना है और इससे हजारों लोगों कच्छ के लोगों को रोजगारी मिले ऐसा इस रण को बनाना है नहीं तो भूकंप में हमारा कच्छ बनी सब ऐसा हो गया था कि अभी पता नहीं होगा कि नहीं लेकिन आज वो पूरा दुनिया यहाँ आती है इतना अच्छा हो गया है ये नरेंद्र मोदी साहब की मेहरबानी है
नरेंद्र मोदी जी के हिसाब से हमारा कच्छ खड़ा हो पाया फिर अब जो हम कच्छ में जाते हैं तो ऐसा हरा भरा कच्छ दिखता है सारे लोग ऐसे अपने सब सुखी अब खुद के बिजनेस सुखी खुद का काम है कुछ ना कुछ काम धंधा करते
नरेंद्र मोदी not only undertook the task of physically rebuilding Kutch, but also sought to instill a sense of pride among the local people. In Bhuj, the Smriti Van, a memorial and museum, was constructed to honor those who lost their lives in the earthquake. Additionally, the Veer Balak Smarak was erected in Anjar to commemorate the children who tragically perished in the seismic event. In an effort to preserve the cultural heritage, many historically significant buildings which suffered damages, such as Gurdwara Lakhpat Sahib, were reconstructed. Various studies and reports underscore the 2001 Kutch earthquake as a pivotal moment that transformed India's approach to handling natural disasters and other crises. This seismic event served as a catalyst, propelling the nation towards a more resilient future. The Kutch model, distinguished not only by its scale and complexity, but also by its forward-thinking approach, laid the groundwork for reimagining existing disaster response models. Kutch's response set the course for a more prepared tomorrow. After establishing a foundation for prosperity in Kutch, Narendra Modi extended his efforts to create a well-prepared Gujarat. Introducing an innovative paradigm for disaster management, Modi emphasized principles such as innovation, community involvement, and readiness. He introduced to the world a new paradigm of disaster management. Following the United Nations Declaration of the Decade of the 90s as an international decade for natural disaster reduction, Narendra Modi embarked on a journey to make Gujarat disaster resilient in the following decade. Witness significant global and Indian efforts to enhance cooperation and strengthen disaster preparedness and risk mitigation. The Yoga Framework, a pivotal development in disaster preparedness and risk mitigation, emerged from the influential World Conference on Disaster Reduction held in January 2005 in Kobe of Hyogo, Japan. In India, the state of Gujarat, led by Chief Minister Narendra Modi, took a pioneering role with the enactment of the GSDM policy in 2003. Gujarat set the stage for the introduction of the Disaster Management Act at the national level in 2005. This marked a transformative period not only for India but also for global initiatives aimed at addressing and mitigating the impact of natural disasters. Both Morbi in 1979, where Narendra Modi experienced the grim reality of a disaster-struck zone, and the Kutch earthquake in 2001, left a deep imprint on his mind. He realized that the state needed a more robust mechanism in dealing with disasters and their aftermath. Gujarat as a state always faced a significant vulnerability to natural disasters. Positioned in the Himalayan collision zone, where the Indo-Australian tectonic plate interacts with the Eurasian plate, active fault lines create seismic concerns. Additionally, Gujarat's extensive coastline exposes it to the threat of cyclones. Given his role as Chief Minister, Narendra Modi recognized the imperative for substantial change. Remarkably, Modi directed his attention to a critical area often overlooked by political leaders in India: disaster preparedness. The Kutch earthquake prompted the state to reassess its disaster response and relief mechanisms. Just a few weeks after the earthquake on the 8th of February in 2001, the Gujarat government established the Gujarat State Disaster Management Authority, GSDMA, chaired by the Chief Minister and comprising key cabinet ministers and top bureaucrats. The GSDMA took on critical responsibilities, including coordination of disaster prevention and mitigation activities, managing post-disaster reconstruction and rehabilitation, and promoting awareness. During its early years, the GSDMA developed guidelines and policies for better disaster management. Notably, under Narendra Modi's leadership, Gujarat passed its Disaster Management Bill in March 2003, making it the first state in India to introduce such legislation.
After Kutch episode, और disaster management भी एक subject उन्होंने देश के सामने रखा. Disaster management का भी एक अलग विभाग होना चाहिए, उसकी चिंता करनी चाहिए.
Following the effective handling of the post-2001 Kutch earthquake, significant lessons learned led to the enactment of the Disaster Management Act by the Union Government in December 2005. In the same year, the National Disaster Management Authority, NDMA, serving as the apex body for disaster management in India, was established. Subsequently, in January 2006, the National Disaster Response Force, NDRF, came into existence.
Mostly, reconstruction programs end as reconstruction programs. But in Gujarat, post-disaster reconstruction was integrated with long-term disaster risk reduction. Permanent institutions and legal frameworks were put in place to manage future disasters effectively. Gujarat became the second state in the country to come out with a policy for disaster management. In 2003, Gujarat came out with an act for disaster management, and Gujarat was the first state to come out with an act for managing disasters.
In addition to the GSDMA, notable institutions that were established in Gujarat during this period include the Gujarat Institute of Disaster Management and the Institute of Seismological Research.
GIDM ki governing council ki pehli baithak mein Modi saab ne GIDM ko tezi se viksit karne ke liye bahut visisht avlokan kiye, jaise ki GIDM ko bade paimane par web based या टेक्नोलॉजी बेस्ड ऑनलाइनिंग ट्रेनिंग प्रोग्राम तैयार करके हर एक व्यक्ति तक पहुंचने का प्रयास करना चाहिए.
Under Chief Minister Narendra Modi's leadership, the strategy encompassed not only established global standard institutions, but also creating a technology-driven information system. E-governance played a pivotal role in this approach. Gujarat launched the Gujarat Statewide Area Network, serving as the backbone of disaster communication infrastructure. The State Disaster Resource Network, SDRN, a web-based resource database, was established to gather and collate information about the availability of human resources, equipment, and other essentials. The real test of Gujarat's newly introduced disaster preparedness model came during the Surat floods in 2006. During this crisis, timely warning messages were disseminated to citizens through SMS, FM radio and other channels, significantly reducing the number of fatalities. The handling of the disaster, encompassing rescue, relief and rehabilitation, was efficiently executed, allowing the industrial city of Surat to return to normalcy within a remarkable 72-hour time frame.
उस टाइम के मुख्यमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी जी सूरत आए हुए थे और उन्होंने एक अच्छा डिसीजन लिया कि गुजरात के जितने मंत्री है उन सबको इधर बुला लिया था और सूरत के जितने एरियाज थे वो सबको अलग अलग रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी बांट दिया था कि मोदी जी के ऐसे डिसीजन की वजह से ये सूरत दोबारा कुछ दिनों के अंदर करीब 5 से 10 दिनों में दोबारा ओरिजिनल सूरत के जैसे हो गया था।
टू एस्टैब्लिश अ सेंट्रलाइज्ड कमांड एंड कंट्रोल फैसिलिटी फॉर इमरजेंसी प्रिपेयर्डनेस एंड डिजास्टर मैनेजमेंट, अ स्टेट इमरजेंसी ऑपरेशन सेंटर वाज इंस्टीट्यूटेड। Chief Minister Modi advocated decentralization. The authority to respond to calamities was delegated to district collectors and local authorities. Consequently, district disaster management plans were formulated. Presently, Gujarat boasts comprehensive disaster management plans at taluka, city and village levels.
CM's focus was very clear: to deal with issues of public, basically the district authorities and taluka level authorities are the prime respondents. In any emergency situations, these both authorities at district and taluka level have to respond, and how to deal with emergency situations, they have to upgrade their knowledge and skills.
Gujarat embarked on a comprehensive initiative to prepare both the populace and the administration to handle emergency situations. Various capacity building activities, including orientation programs, training sessions, practical demonstrations, and awareness campaigns, were systematically conducted at all levels: village, taluka, city, municipal corporation, and district.
हम लोगों ने स्कूलों में सेफ्टी का प्रोग्राम शुरू किया। ये एक अपने आप में प्रोग्राम है जिसमें हर स्कूल में जाकर उसकी जो अपनी भी वल्नरेबिलिटी है उसको एसेस किया जाए। फिर वहाँ पर सभी छात्रों को जितने भी टीचर्स हैं, मैनेजमेंट है, उनकी ट्रेनिंग की जाए किस तरह से आपदा प्रबंधन, प्रिपेयर्डनेस, अगर कभी आपदा आ जाए तो आप अपने जाने कैसे बचाएं।
अनदर इम्पॉर्टेंट प्रोग्राम वॉज ट्रेनिंग वॉलंटियर्स। नॉर्मली व्हाट हैपेंस इज व्हेन अ डिजास्टर हैपेंस, लॉट ऑफ वॉलंटियर्स कम टू हेल्प। दिस इज व्हाट इज कॉल्ड स्पॉन्टेनियस वॉलंटियरिज्म। स्पॉन्टेनियसली दे कम टू हेल्प, बट इफ दे डोंट नो व्हाट दे शुड डू, and if they don't have the capacity to do, if they don't have adequate training, not only that they will not be of help to the affected people, they will put their lives also in danger.
Emphasizing preparedness and mitigation as its twin pillars, the Gujarat disaster management model under Narendra Modi departed from the traditional reactive approach, opting proactive route. In a short span, Gujarat emerged as a pioneering state in establishing a robust mechanism for emergency response.
Bharat Mata Ki, Bharat Mata Ki.
In 2014, a wave of political change swept through India. Narendra Modi, then the Chief Minister of Gujarat, emerged as a symbol of that change. After governing Gujarat for almost 13 years, many saw Narendra Modi as the natural choice for India's next Prime Minister. Modi's proactive approach extended beyond his home state, as demonstrated during the Uttarakhand floods of 2013. Despite being the Chief Minister of another state, Modi not only offered financial and material assistance, but also personally visited the affected areas.
Narendra Modi ji khud Dehradun aaye, aur unhone yeh kaha ki main chahta hu जो पूरी केदार घाटी और जो केदार धाम है इसका पुनर्निर्माण का कार्य आप मुझको दे दें, मुझको मुझ पर छोड़ दें। और दूसरी बात है कि इस आपदा में मेरी सरकार पूरी आपकी मदद करेगी, और 5 करोड़ का चेक उन्होंने मुझे हाथ में दिया आपदा के लिए।
नरेंद्र मोदी हैंड्स ऑन अप्रोच प्लेड अ क्रूशियल रोल ड्यूरिंग द 2014 जनरल इलेक्शंस, रिजल्टिंग इन हिज पार्टी द बीजेपी सिक्योरिंग अ हिस्टोरिक मैंडेट। This mandate marked a historic milestone on multiple fronts, including disaster response readiness. In 2013, the Comptroller and Auditor General CAG released a crucial report highlighting the status of disaster management in India, revealing numerous critical shortcomings. The report noted that the National Executive Committee of Secretaries, tasked with assisting the NDMA, had not convened for several years after May 2008. Despite the occurrence of several disasters during that period. Additionally, the report emphasized the absence of a national plan for disaster management, even 6 years after the enactment of the Disaster Management Act. In response to these challenges, P.K. Mishra, former CEO of GSDMA, led a task force appointed by the Union Home Ministry to review the Disaster Management Act of 2005. The task force recommended empowering the NDMA and granting it the authority to formulate a national plan for disaster management.
मैं नरेंद्र दामोदर दास मोदी ईश्वर की शपथ लेता हूं कि
Shortly after assuming office as the 14th Prime Minister of India, Narendra Modi found himself overseeing relief and rescue operations in flooded Kashmir. Heavy rainfall triggered landslides, causing significant damage to bridges and roads. PM Modi visited the state promptly to assess the situation firsthand. Under his leadership, senior officials, including the Home Secretary, were stationed in the state to coordinate relief and recovery efforts. The army and other forces successfully evacuated tens of thousands of people within record time. Large quantities of food items, including ready-to-eat options, were distributed. Pumps from the Oil and Natural Gas Corporation and other mines were airlifted to pump out water from Srinagar. Hundreds of medical teams were deployed in the field. RO plants with substantial capacity for water filtration were transported from various parts of the country. Thousands of blankets were distributed, and the Jammu-Srinagar National Highway, affected by floods and landslides, was swiftly reopened with the assistance of the Border Roads Organization. Power transmission lines were restored within a few days. Recognizing the inadequacy of the allocated 1,100 crore rupees from the State Disaster Relief Fund in the face of the tragedy, PM Modi immediately allotted an additional special assistance of 1,000 crore rupees from the Union Government of flood relief and rehabilitation in the state.
लेकिन ये हादसा इतना बड़ा है कि 1100 करोड़ से कुछ होना नहीं है और इसलिए आज मैं पहली किस्त के रूप में 1000 करोड़ रुपया और स्पेशल असिस्टेंस के रूप में जम्मू कश्मीर सरकार को देने की का निर्णय मैंने किया है.
The Kashmir floods occurred shortly after Narendra Modi assumed the role of Prime Minister, offering an early opportunity to apply the best practices in disaster management, for which Gujarat had already set a template. In the following days, a cyclone struck parts of Andhra Pradesh and Orissa, prompting Prime Minister Modi to engage with the state governments and offer assistance. This demonstrated PM Modi's commitment to cooperative federalism, as evident in the situations in Kashmir, Andhra Pradesh and Orissa. Narendra Modi consistently made it a point to personally visit areas affected by disasters. Engaging in first-hand assessments, he used to conduct aerial surveys to gauge the extent of damage and destruction. In April 2015, a massive earthquake struck Nepal, prompting a swift response from India, which offered substantial assistance to the Himalayan nation.
Pradhan Mantri ji ka apna bhi anubhav raha hai. Unhone भुज रिकवरी रिकंस्ट्रक्शन में काम किया था 2001 के भूकंप के बाद. वो सारा आप उनसे जब बात करते हैं तो पता चलता है कि उनका अनुभव साफ इसमें झलकता है. जैसा उदाहरण है, उन्होंने कहा कि जिन लोगों के घर क्षतिग्रस्त हो गए हैं और जिनको खुले में या हल्के टेंट्स में रहना पड़ेगा, उनके लिए हमें कुछ ऐसी व्यवस्था करनी चाहिए कि उनको ठंड ना लगे. तो क्या हम उनको ये वार्मिंग वाटर बॉटल्स दे सकते हैं?
During his Mann Ki Baat address on the 29th of November 2015, Prime Minister Modi shared with the public that following the Nepal earthquake, he had proposed the concept of SAARC nations collaborating in a joint exercise on disaster preparedness. On the 1st of June in 2016, Prime Minister Modi unveiled the first ever National Disaster Management Plan developed in the country. The plan was aligned with the four priority themes of the Sendai framework, namely understanding disaster risk, enhancing disaster risk governance, investing in disaster risk reduction, DRR, and most importantly, preparedness. The Sendai framework for DRR 2015-2030 succeeded the Hyogo framework 2005-2015 and was adopted at the World Conference on DRR in Sendai of Japan in June 2015. The plan drew inspiration from many of the approaches Prime Minister Modi had implemented on the ground in Kutch and other areas. In November 2016, a crucial global conference on disaster risk reduction took place in New Delhi. The Asian Ministerial Conference on Disaster Risk Reduction marked the first gathering after the adoption of the Sendai framework. During this event, The Prime Minister delivered a powerful address outlining a significant framework on the subject.
Over the first 5 years of the Sendai framework, we should develop a global network of universities working together on problems of disaster risk management.
At the conference, he presented a 10-point agenda to renew global efforts towards disaster risk reduction. Priority was given to capacity building. Post-2014, the government invested heavily in new technologies, expertise and capacity building, ushering in a new culture of preparedness and resilience. By 2021, at least 33 states and union territories had their approved state disaster management plans in place. However, PM Modi's focus throughout has been community-led resilience. As a volunteer, he experienced community service and led a team of volunteers during Morbi floods in 1979. Later in Kutch, he transformed the disaster management program into a Jana Andolan, a people's movement. When Gujarat was preparing its own model of disaster preparedness, Narendra Modi gave predominant priority to community participation, volunteerism and local capacity building.
एक बड़ा मार्गदर्शन हमें उनसे मिला, वो जन भागीदारी पर था. पहली बार ऐसा हुआ हमारे देश में कि जन भागीदारी को एक पॉलिसी टू एक्शन लिया गया. जो गांव वाले हैं जिनको नुकसान हुआ, उनको तो साथ लिया ही लिया, बट और भी गैर सरकारी संस्थानों को भी, प्राइवेट सेक्टर को भी अपने साथ सरकार ने एक पार्टनर बनाया.
देन द ऑनरेबल प्राइम मिनिस्टर कॉल्स अ स्पेशल मीटिंग. He not only did that, interestingly enough, he also gave us the idea that since the parliament session is on, aside from the coordination that his meeting ensured, he also said that you should speak to the parliamentarians of the areas which are going to get impacted by this cyclone. So in the same evening, the concerned MPs were requested to attend a briefing by us and other experts on how they can spread the word to their constituents.
Modi championed a unique program to train volunteers known as Aapda Mitras.
कि NDMA की आपदा मित्र जैसी स्कीम से युवा आगे आ रहे हैं.
The Subhash Chandra Bose Aapda Prabandhan Puraskar was established to honor individuals and organizations making notable contributions to disaster management. Another example of India's enhanced ability to avert disasters came to light when a ship carrying crude for the Indian Oil Limited caught fire in the ocean, leading to a possible oil spill in 2020. The disaster was contained in a short time due to timely intervention of the government and the Prime Minister.
And it was eventually extinguished on 9th of September through the relentless efforts of number of authorities. The Honorable Prime Minister Sri Narendra Modi ji was very keenly following the developments of the MT New Diamond case. And it was under his interventions that swift and coordinated efforts were launched by different wings of the government to contain the damage and mitigate the risks.
In 2019, PM Modi took this idea one step further when he launched the Coalition for Disaster Resilient Infrastructure, CDRI. This coalition comprises of 34 countries, including the United States, Germany, Italy, and numerous other developed and developing nations. On the 28th of August 2019, the Union Cabinet of India took a significant stride by approving the establishment of CDRI, designating New Delhi as its headquarters, and allocating a support fund of ₹480 crores. Prime Minister Narendra Modi views disaster management as a global concern, rather than solely a national or state-level issue. In recent times, India has emerged as a reliable initial responder during disasters in various parts of the world. India played a pivotal role as the primary responder during the Nepal earthquake. In the aftermath of the Turkey-Syria earthquake, India was among the earliest to respond and participate in relief operations. Starting in 2014, India actively advanced towards a state of enhanced preparedness, driven by a unique vision, emphasizing long-term resilience. This approach aimed at uniting the entire nation and the global community in the pursuit of a safer planet. The spirit of a resilient nation was carried forward when an unprecedented pandemic struck not only India but the world. COVID-19 brought the world almost to its knees. However, India, under the leadership of Prime Minister Narendra Modi, stunned the world with its efficient handling of the situation. India not only enforced effective lockdowns to curb the spread of the onslaught, but it also managed to keep its economy on track. India was one of the few countries that manufactured not one but two incredibly effective vaccines, Covaxin and Covishield. For the first time in the history of the country, Prime Minister Modi invoked the Disaster Management Act of 2005 and the Epidemic Diseases Act of 1897 as the primary legal frameworks for containing the pandemic.
The COVID-19 pandemic that changed history, and the India COVID story, how we have been able to handle it, how we've been able to bring out these vaccines, diagnostics, ventilators, PPEs, masks. It is a story that every Indian is proud of.
From his first-hand experience of disaster handling in Morbi in 1979 to the rebuilding of Kutch after the devastating earthquake in 2001, Narendra Modi's pragmatic approach towards disaster handling became the turning point in modern India's pursuit towards a new paradigm of disaster management. After being ignored for several decades, Narendra Modi brought this important subject to the forefront of governance. Under his leadership, Gujarat became the first state to introduce a Disaster Management Act in 2003, even before one such law was introduced at the national level. He focused on capacity building, based on his principle of Aapda Mein Avsar, and aimed at better disaster preparedness. Prime Minister Narendra Modi's approach marked a new beginning towards a resilient India. India is now recognized as a global first responder in crisis situations. Today, India's come a long way. With improved preparedness, advanced risk reduction capabilities, a robust framework for disaster management, and a vision for resilience, India stands stronger than ever.